Pencilish Animation Studios has finally dropped their first series, and that means that today's video is going to be all about Bjorn the Last Unicorn. The episode dropped just a few days ago on April 8th and already has over 29,000 views. Just a heads up, I will be posting the link to the actual first episode itself right down below, so you can go ahead and go watch that and enjoy the first episode of the first series that Pencilish Animation Studios has produced for us. Now, I do want to put one thing out there right in the beginning. I am an investor in Pencilish Animation Studios company. But I think that means that I'm going to be all the more critical about what it is that's going to be discussed here and what I would like to see moving forward in the Bjorn the Last Unicorn series. Now, the video is going to be split into two different parts. The first part is going to be about my impressions and sort of more technical things, and the second part is going to be about the actual community, sort of the feedback and comments that we've received after people have watched the first episode of Bjorn the Last Unicorn. So let's go ahead and dive into the actual introduction of the episode and move in chronological order. We start off with the first episode giving us the final introduction to the animated series. I think this is probably the most solid aspect of the entire 5 minutes that we got out of this short. The music was awesome, it was fun, it was intriguing, the jingle for Bjorn was really great, and it was definitely on par with other animated shows that we could see on Disney Channel, on Nickelodeon, on Cartoon Network, even other independent studios that we see on YouTube, on Facebook, and on Instagram. And so this is leagues better than the hint and sort of early introduction that we got in the trailer to Bjorn the Last Unicorn just a few weeks ago. I think they really honed down what it is that they want. They improved the graphics. They really got the jingle, which I really loved. And I think that's really key to providing some sort of personality behind Bjorn as a character. And I think that the only thing that I would mention, a slight caveat, would be that I do think that they need to replace some of the actual video footage in that introduction with either media that is not related to any episode in particular showing Bjorn and the other characters, or, as you know, time goes along, inserting different clips from other episodes to be inserted in that introduction so that we're not seeing only clips from the first episode every single time that we're, you know, starting a new episode of Bjorn the Last Unicorn. And so the introduction finishes, we're brought onto this background, this spectacular view with really great special effects that is Bjorn's mountain, and where the whole entire episode is going to take place in this one setting. And so right after that, we immediately get to see the animation and we get to start off with the story. I love the rough animation that we saw. In case you're wondering why this looks a little bit different from normal other animated series, the studio is really harping on rough animation, rough 2D animation. Now, this is going to be different from the cleaned up animation, as we call it, within other shows. And this really allows the studio to be able to produce more content without spending months trying to clean up the animation. Obviously, the quality will get better as the episodes go on and the crew improves over time. But I really love seeing this because, personally, I really love rough 2D animation. I think that it really emphasizes more on the importance of story and fluidity of the actual animation that we see in itself, and realizing that we're really here for the story and the characters rather than this really solid, tied down quality of animation that we're seeing on screen. Now, for the timing of the short, we got 5 minutes, and we were looking for about 3 to 5 minutes within the first episodes that we were seeing. This one reached a full 5 minutes with 3 minutes of credits, and even though that was the actual time that we were looking for, I do think that that was too short, and we're going to be moving into the next segment here, which is going to be about what the community side sort of said, and I think this is the key reason for why there were a few different disputes and disagreements between what we actually received and how we were hoping for things that may have been a little bit improved upon or better in some cases. So what we're really seeing is sort of a mixed reaction between really positive comments and sort of a need for improvement. And there's two things that I'm really going to be moving on here. And the first one is going to be sound and the narrator. I think this is something that could be fixed really easily, but definitely does need to be pointed out. The second one is a little bit more tedious, and that's about plot and the significance of characters. So let's start off with sound and the narrator. there were two different segments where I really sort of saw this stand out and agreed with different people who said that they had problems understanding what the narrator was saying. The first portion was, we were moving out of the introduction. We get the first sort of introduction to the series, and the narrator's talking to us about who the unicorns are, what their history is, and talking about how Bjorn's the last unicorn. And within the first 4 seconds, as we were showing Bjorn as he's sitting on his pile of hay as he's sleeping, the narrator's voice got completely drowned out by the onset of music and sound effects and the actual voice that started coming from the dialogue of Bjorn itself. And so I didn't understand and even catch what the narrator was saying. The second portion was when we're looking at the very end of the episode and Bjorn is jumping in the backpack. He's ready to go on his adventure, and the narrator starts talking again. And I think the problem is that we're seeing a narrator's voice that's really rustic. It's very atmospheric, which I really love, which sort of ties it into this sort of fantasy aspect of this story tale that we're listening to. But the problem is that it's super difficult to understand and make out what the narrator's saying. And so I think if we look back to the actual trailer for Bjorn the Unicorn, the first narrator that spoke in the first portion of this trailer, we got a really clear voice that came from the narrator. And then a few moments later in the first trailer, we hear the narrator that we have now. It became more rustic, it became more fairy tale like, it was a deeper voice, but it was more, we're talking in this story sense. And that made it a little bit more difficult to understand. And so if I think we can deal with the technical aspects of not getting all these different sounds jumbled out or the narrator's voice drowning or fading out, and we can also get sort of a more clear voice, that could really, really help us for being able to fully understand all the dialogue and not have to play it back a few times to understand what it is that the narrator's actually saying. Now, the next part is going to be really the bulk of this, and that's going to be about plot and significance of characters. Part of this deals with Bjorn himself, but it also deals with the other characters that we had seen. There were a few comments about this, and I definitely think this is one of the biggest issues, which is the actual understanding and lack of believability within the first episode that people saw when it came to Bjorn in social media. We know that the whole plot of this sort of series is reaching out to several different audiences, in the sense that they're trying to have this kid's show which has the fun aspects of a unicorn, sort of fairy tale sort of stuff, and rainbows, and this kind of fun jokes with moving rocks and all that sort of stuff. We also have the other different audience, which is a teen slash young adult audience, and that's going to be focusing around social media and what it means to be an influencer, and this, our society, how it's caught up within social media, the good, the bad, and the ugly. And then we've got the grown adult sort of issues and commentary and jokes that we're seeing between Becca and Chad as we're talking about relationship issues and how her life's going to be moving forward and what she's looking for happiness in her life. And so we're sort of moving between several different audiences, but I think where that kind of becomes a problem as we're trying to figure out who is Bjorn and what is he looking for. And I think this is what we're talking about when this 5 minutes wasn't enough, is we got about a few different segments of 20 seconds each where we saw Bjorn. He just received the phone that had fallen out of Chad's hands. He goes back into his den and he spends a night looking at social media. And really the questions that I have, which made this really just confusing and unbelievable, was the sense that he knew what the word influencer meant. He immediately knew how to use a smartphone. And the questions I had is, how does he know what social media is overnight? How is he able to compare it to the world of the past? There's one quote he says where everyone is so happy and fulfilled and respectful of each other. There's definitely no sign of toxic or unhealthy coping mechanisms. And that was really hilarious, but obviously that would go over kids' heads. And it seems like that's something that's tying into sort of the young adult sort of audience. But when we're hearing that, we're saying, well, how does Bjorn know anything about this? How is he like able to swipe through a phone and be able to work a phone without ever having one before? And so it just seemed really confusing, especially within overnight, within a period of, I think, about 30 seconds, he comes to really the key of the series where he says, I'm going to become a social media influencer and probably the best in the world. And we're wondering, why is this his objective? You know, why is it that he knows what this is and that that's what it is that I want to do, and I gotta go find Becca as he sees her, and she's the one who's gonna help me, and because she's dealing with her cat, who's sort of a social media influencer. And I think this was just something that was really lacking. It would need much more time so that we can get this sense of, first, a segment of him figuring out, what is a phone? What is this I'm seeing? How do I work it, you know, and dealing with that. The next, which is, what is social media and what is this all about? And the third part, which is, oh, you can become a social media influencer. You could be someone who helps bring joy and cheer to the world, you know? And so those are three different parts we have to deal with, which I felt like were rushed and need some more time, which is why people were asking this question of, why is it that I don't feel any attachment to these characters? I feel this lack of significance. I don't feel like, I don't really feel like I should continue with this series because I don't feel any emotional investment. I don't understand, you know, why it is that I should care about this when it's so rushed. It doesn't seem believable. I just don't feel like I have that attachment towards it. And so I think that's something that really needs to be fleshed out as we move down the line. And in the next few series that we see coming from the studio, we need to see that sort of attention being paid to, okay, here's our character, here's our objective, here's where the series is going, and this is what they want in life. And why is it that they want this? How is it that they've come to this character arc, which is they've made this decision? You know, and I feel like that was kind of rushed. I think it can be fixed if we spend a little bit more time on it, but that definitely needs to be fixed in the future. Another question that I personally had is, how important is his magic and how much will it influence the story? Is this going to be something that really ties in to Bjorn and how he becomes successful in social media? Is this going to be, he's got this magic where he can make a sled just appear, you know, from his horn? Does that mean he's going to be tying magic into the real world? Is that going to cause problems for him? Is it going to cause, like, great adventures? Is going to be really cool, you know? Is this going to be sort of a traveling thing, or how's this going to affect domestic life if he's living at home with Becca and some of these other characters? And so I think we need to see how useful this is going to be, and we'll just have to wait and see how that is. But I really think that provides some awesome opportunities for the story to create these really wacky sort of adventures, but also create this sort of completely fictional character. Fictional in the sense he's a unicorn, but fictional in the sense beyond that, which is like we bring in all these other fantastical things and we create these really cool stories that are great for all different audiences. So all in all, I'm really excited to be able to see what the next series bring us, especially War Pigs, which we just got a quick glimpse of the other day, and I'm really, really happy to see that. I think some of these other series that they're going for are going to be really, really great, and so I think this was a first test run for them. So what to say about this test run? I think that plot and character development and believability were really lacking and were really rushed. But as far as the animation went and just sort of dipping our toes in the water and seeing where this is going to move on from here, I think that there's really great potential. I think we're going to see some phenomenal series coming out of this, some really great stories that we're going to be able to improve upon these sorts of things. And the studio is going to be able to push forward and say, okay, we've tried this out. We sort of saw the reaction. And I think that we can make some really quality content after this that's going to be aimed at different audiences. It's also going to be really fun bringing in our own unique animation styles that are, you know, really rough, but also really intriguing and story-driven and bring the attention of people back. But there is still that lack of cohesiveness within the story that does need to be fixed. Thank you for watching. Please go support the official release of Bjorn the Unicorn. I think it's going to be a really good show in the future, and that it's going to be something that's going to become really popular that a lot of people are really going to love. Go support the studio. Leave a like, leave a comment on their page. Tell them what you think about it. I'll see you in the next video, and have a great day.